Hello everyone and welcome to another Snapshot video. It's been a while since I've done one of these, but welcome to 12W49A. Now this isn't for 1.5, but actually for 1.4.6. This is an update that Jeb wanted to do because he wanted fireworks to be added for New Year's, and this means that 1.5 is probably going to be released in January and maybe even February. But let's have a look at what's been added in this snapshot. So as you can see straight away, we have these nether brick slabs. People have been wanting these for a while, so they've been added. Pretty simple, but there we go, we can add them together. There we go, work just like normal slabs on top or below. But let's go ahead and look at the other things that have been added. So one of the other major ones is this type of book here. If we go to the enchant, we place in a normal book, not a book and quill, just a normal book, and you will see that you can enchant the book. So we go here and we're going to grab 30, and that's going to give us projectile protection 4. So there we have this enchanted book. Now what you can do with this is if you go to an anvil, you can place, we've already got something here, but if we grab, let's just grab this diamond chest plate here. We're going to pop it in and then we're going to place this enchanted book. And as you can see, it gives that item the enchant. So if you want to sell certain enchants, perhaps you can have this as sort of an economy on a server where you sell certain types of enchants, or you can use this for an adventure map, anything like that. But there you go. You can put any sort of enchantment you want inside of a book. Well, you can't pick, but obviously if you keep making loads of different enchanted books, you don't have to waste all these different armors and weapons in order to get the enchantment you want. You just waste books, go through more and more and more and more books. And then when you find the one you want, you just jump to the anvil and then you pop it in there with your item of choice. But let's go ahead and look at the main thing that's been added inside of this snapshot. The awesomeness that is fireworks. Now, I'm sure many of you may have seen before the mod review that I did of the Hanabi mod, a Japanese-made fireworks mod. This is actually pretty similar, but it has a lot more customization choices. So we're going to go here to the crafting table. You may notice that I do have too many items for this snapshot, and we will come back to that in a minute, and I'll show you something pretty awesome with that. But if we grab here a piece of gunpowder, we can now add a colour. So there we go, we've added blue, and it creates this firework star. Now this one has a small blue here, which is a small blue firework star. But let's add another colour, let's add magenta, and I don't know, yellow, just some random colors here. And you can see that they've been added. So we've got small blue, yellow, blue, magenta, firework star. But we have these other items here. If we add a creeper head, you can see that it actually changes it to creeper shaped. So we can have a creeper shaped firework. Or if we put that back and put glowstone dust, you can see that it has a twinkle. You can combine more of these. Let's put a fire charge in and we get a large ball instead of a small ball. And then we can place in a diamond, and that will give us a trail. So there we go, we have a nice collection there. So we've got a large ball with a trail and a twinkle in yellow, blue, and magenta. And there we go, let's make the firework star. So now we've got the firework star, we can place some paper down and some gunpowder down in any formation you want, they all work. And you will get your firework rocket. As you can see there, it's got flight duration 1. And then it's got all the settings, so it's a large ball, yellow, blue, magenta, trail, and twinkle. You can add more gunpowder, there we go, you can see. Now it only seems to add up to 3, however, you do have the option to go up to 5, just not with this normal crafting recipe. So there we go, we have a flight duration of 3, that basically means that it will fly higher. So if you were making some sort of fireworks show, you can have them coming at different heights. They do also, we'll show you in a minute, they do actually fly in different patterns. So you may not have to worry about the flight duration too much, depending on how you want your fireworks show to look. So instead of that, let's take these out. And we can actually place some more colours in. So we could do yellow, red, and what you can see here is that this is actually the fade to colour. So what we can do is if we take these out, we can put in a... where have we got it? We haven't got any bone meal. So let's go ahead and find some bone meals in here somewhere. Looking down. Okay, there we've got our bone meal. So we can place this down, and what that would do is it will fade to white, almost like, you can have like a twinkle of the real fireworks with the white. So we're going to do that. But you can set that to any color you want. So we're going to set ours fade to white. So there we go, we have that. We're going to grab our paper, our gunpowder, and then grab our firework rocket. And because it's night, we'll just go up here, and just place it down. And woo! And as you can see there, it has the colors. It faded to white. It had the big massive ball, the twinkle. What else did it have? And the trail. There we go. Look at that. Absolutely wonderful. Now, these can actually be placed into dispensers, which I have in this rather lame setup here with some dispensers over there. But firstly, I just want to show you this function with too many items. As you can see here, it now has a new option with the too many items for this snapshot, which will be coming out for 1.4.6, where you can set all the different things. So instead of having to craft it all manually and everything like that, you just go here, we can set, let's have it to creeper shape. We'll put a flicker in, no trail, flight of 5. We can call it a name, so creeper, bomb. Let's have it like that. And then we could do different colours, so let's just set random colours here. Like that, there we go. And then we can make, like that, and then we go, we get a stack of 64. These creeper bombs, flight duration 5, creeper shaped blue, purple blue, fatal lime, magenta grey, with a twinkle. And we'll set that off. And woo, God, that's going high. Wow, I think that's gone too high for me. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to do that again, but we're going to set the flight to 1 that time. Okay, make, and boom. Okay, we're at the wrong angle there, so we go up again. Wow, look at that, it's a creeper phase. Hello, creeper. And wow. Okay, isn't that amazing? You see it's twinkling and fading down to these different colors. Just amazing. So they also have the ability inside of too many items. In fact, that didn't actually destroy the item there. Just made me chuck it down. Okay. They do have a few preset ones. If we go back here, you can see that they have Creepy Sparkler, Star, Big Red, and Old Glory. So let's take a look at those. We're going to chuck all these away. Like so. And we do actually have, you could have seen Gold Nugget, Feather, also do different things here. I'll just quickly show you. We just go to Gunpowder. We go to Blue. We make that, then we go again, we can place feathered, in fact we didn't need to do it in that order. We have to do this before, something I keep forgetting to do. So let's do that again, gunpowder, blue, and then we're going to add golden nugget, and that adds, okay, that makes it star shaped, and feather, actually that seems to clash, so we take that away. Oh, that makes a burst, okay, so we have a burst, make that, and give it a nice fader red, like that, we give it 2 gunpowder and 1 paper, and there we go, we got our flight duration, burst, purple, and to red. Fire that off, and there you can see, wow, okay, so that wasn't very attractive, that was quite a small explosion, but there we go, there's another one. So let's have a look at what we've got here. So we've got Creepy Sparkler, Star, Big Red, and Old Glory. So place this one, I think this is a creeper one. In a nice green, yeah, we can't really see that well, so let's fire a few off and go up here and have a look. There you go, you can, oh wow, and it fades to orange. Is that orange? Okay, it's, yeah, fade to orange, that's amazing. Okay, and the next one, which is, oh, wow, okay. That flies up into the distance, let's fire a few more and go up here and we can see. It should have a little blue explosion, there we go. And then the next one, I love this one, is just a big, massive red ball. Isn't that lovely? Let's fire a few of those off. Wow. Okay. And then the last one is Old Glory, which is a very nice Americanized red, white, and blue. This is actually 3 times this has gone through. You can see we've got 3 different things, and it all goes off in the same thing. So you can see it goes flash. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. There you go. So with these, I decided to put some dispensers at the back, wired with this very, very poor redstone clock. And let's grab some redstone here and finish off the circuit. And let's enjoy the fireworks show. And here we go. Wow. There we go. Our fireworks show. And that is pretty much just working off of a clock onto redstone wire. I'll just quickly show the wire so you can see what's actually going on down here. I changed the clock time here because when you change it to that, it didn't really work. It just stayed solid. So I made it there, and there you go. It seems to flash. And it goes all the way to the back here where we've got 2 dispensers that are just wired up. And they're just full of these preset ones which actually come with too many items. These are not only custom-made ones. These are ones that you get in too many items. And there we go. Look at that. Absolutely brilliant. Wonderful. Lovely. So you can have all sorts of custom, oh look, there's creeper ones, custom fireworks for your custom fireworks shows. I'm absolutely in love with this. This is absolutely amazing. And I'm going to leave it there for this video. Let's stand up here and let's enjoy the show. So if you've enjoyed the video, please let me know by rating, commenting and subscribing. If you want to check me out on Facebook and Twitter, you can find links in the description below. But until next time, thank you for watching and goodbye.